हेलो,
हेलो मैम, गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग। कैन यू हियर मी प्रॉपरली?
यस यस मैम।
ओके, होप द स्लाइड्स आर आल्सो विजिबल।
या यस मैम।
ओके, सो लेट अस वेट फॉर 5 मिनट्स। After that, we will start the class. Let others also join. Okay.
ओके मैम।
Okay, shall we start?
Yes, ma'am.
Good morning, all of you.
Good morning, ma'am.
Hope all are doing fine.
Good morning, ma'am.
Okay, yes, so in the last class, we were dealing with the various theories of learning as well as learning theory of personality. We know that what is learning? Do you remember the definition which I gave to you? So we know that the learning, it is a continuous process in our life, and the definition states that learning, it is a relatively permanent change in behavior that occurs as a result of experience. So in this definition, it is mentioned that through learning, some behavioral changes takes place. And these behavioral changes takes place as a result of practice as well as experience. And when we talk about the various theories of learning in personality, mainly we have to deal with the Pavlov's theory as well as Skinner's theory. So in the syllabus, these two theories are there. And what are the various theories of learning? Do you remember? That is, one is classical conditioning. It is by Pavlov, and operant conditioning, then law of effect. These are the various theories of learning. And the classical conditioning, you know that it is also called, it is a type of learning, and it is also called the Pavlovian conditioning. And what is conditioning? Conditioning means it is a reaction or response to an object. Object in the sense stimulus, and by a person or animal, and it can be modified by learning or conditioning. So after conditioning, the behavior or response become more frequent, and also it becomes more predictable. So that we call as the, that stage we call as the conditioning. So in short, the conditioning means it is a response to a particular stimulus, and it happens inside a person, and this type of behavior, it can be modified by learning or conditioning. Then today we are going to deal with the theory by Skinner, or it is also called, and do you remember the various stages of classical conditioning? In conditioning, there are three stages. Last class we had already gone through that. Three stages in classical conditioning. That is, first is before conditioning, then during conditioning, what happens, and after conditioning. Remember?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Hope it is clear. And what are the key principles of classical conditioning? There are five. Acquisition. Then
extinction.
Extinction. Yes.
Generalization and discrimination.
Yes. Spontaneous recovery, stimulus generalization, and last is the stimulus discrimination. These are the five key principles of classical conditioning. And yes, now today we are going to deal with operant conditioning. So operant, the term itself says that something operates. So this is also a method of learning. This operant conditioning, it is also a method of learning. And we can say that this type of learning occurs through rewards and punishment. Appo ee oru learning, ee operant conditioning la, it was proposed by Skinner, B.F. Skinner. And this type of learning here also, it is also, we can say that operant conditioning, it is also a method of learning. And this type of particular learning occurs through rewards and punishment for behavior. Appo namukku oru stimulus vannu, we are behaving in a particular way, and for that behavior some type of learning occurs, because occurs through rewards or punishment. So we can say that through operant conditioning, an association is made between the behavior and a consequence for that behavior. Appo ee oru particular behavior la, the important thing is that some type of association happens, or some type of association, it is made between the behavior and a consequence for that behavior. So I'll make it clear. Before that, who is the father of operant conditioning? B.F. Skinner. This person, B.F. Skinner, is regarded as the father of operant conditioning. And Skinner studied operant conditioning by conducting experiments using animals, just like Pavlov also. Pavlov conducted his experiment with the help of a dog. Similarly, B.F. Skinner, he also conducted he studied the operant conditioning by conducting experiments using animals. And for this, he used a box called the Skinner box. This is very important, Skinner box. He used the box called the Skinner box for his experiment. Appo ithre manasilaya baaki njan paranju thara ee association okke engine varane nu ee experiment paranju kayumbo manasilavu. Appo B.F. Skinner is regarded as the father of operant conditioning, and Skinner studied operant conditioning by conducting experiments using animal. Next is what is Skinner box? He conducted his experiment with the help of this apparatus called the Skinner box. And now let us look what that experiment is. So you know that what is the name of that apparatus? Skinner box. The Skinner box vechittana experiment conduct cheyathu. So the experiment is that inside the Skinner box, and as I mentioned that Skinner studied the operant conditioning with the help of an animal, and he used the rat for his experiment. But Pavlov dog in and use that here Skinner used a rat for his experiment. So inside the Skinner box, when the rat was placed inside the Skinner box, and the Skinner box consists of two buttons, one blue button and one red button. Appo ee Skinner box la rat ne ittu, adine shesham ee Skinner box la rendu button undu, one is a blue button and the other is red button. So inside the Skinner box, when the rat presses a blue button, what happens? The rat receives a food pellet as a reward. Appo rendu button undu, blue button undu, red button undu. When the rat presses the blue button, the rat will get a food pellet. Oru food pellet kittum, and we can consider it as a reward. Appo rat endana blue button press cheyina samayathu ratinu oru food pellet kittum. We can call it as a reward. Alla appo ratinu pettana oru vishinirikkunna oru rat aanundengi blue button press cheyumbo oru pellet food pellet kittumbo the rat consider it as a reward. But on the other hand, when the rat presses the red button, it receives a mild electric shock. Appo rat red button press cheyina samayathu endana oru cheriya oru electric shock kittum. Then what will be the result? Appo ratina if endana red button blue button enda idonnu ratina arilla, but accidentally when rat presses the blue button, it will get a food pellet. But when it presses the by accident it accidentally it presses the blue sorry red button, what happens? It gets a mild electric shock. That was what happened. Then what is the result? Now let us examine what happened or what is the result. The rat learns to press the blue button to get the reward. Kore attempt kaniye irimbo ee electric shock kittunu parayumbo it is an unpleasant experience. So gradually the rat learned that when it presses the blue button, it will definitely get a reward. Also at the same time, it learns to avoid the red button, because getting an electric shock means it is an unpleasant experience, or it might be a little bit painful, so that it can stay away from the shock. Appa idu padukka gradually the rat learns to avoid the red button endinana so that it can stay away from the electric shock. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Appo Skinner, he used the Skinner box to conduct the experiment, and he used which animal? which animal for his experiment?
Rat.
Rat. You see, this is the same thing. This is the same thing. Skinner is the animal. You see, the Pavlov is the same thing. But we have Skinner is the same thing. മാറാറുണ്ട് പലർക്കും. അപ്പോൾ ഇതാണ് എക്സ്പെരിമെന്റ്. അപ്പൊ സ്കിന്നർ ബോക്സിൽ രണ്ട് ബട്ടൺ ആണുള്ളത്, റെഡ് ആൻഡ് ബ്ലൂ ബട്ടൺ. റെഡ് ബട്ടൺ പ്രസ് ചെയ്യുമ്പോൾ എന്താണ്, ദ റാറ്റ് ഇറ്റ് റിസീവ്സ് എ മൈൽഡ് ഇലക്ട്രിക് ഷോക്ക്. മറ്റേ ബ്ലൂ ബട്ടൺ ആണെങ്കിൽ ഇറ്റ് വിൽ ഗെറ്റ് ആസ് എ get a food pellet. Appa ee food pellet kittu ennu parnja it is a pleasurable experience, so the rat consider it as a reward. Appa ingane palappulum accidentally idinatha press cheyina samayathe red press cheyina samayathe irikkum chalappo oru shock kittunnathu. Appa endana gradually it start associating red button press cheyumba shock kittum, adu painful aanu. അങ്ങനെ പതുക്കെ അത് അസോസിയേറ്റ് ചെയ്യാൻ തുടങ്ങും. സോ ദാറ്റ് ഇറ്റ് ക്യാൻ സ്റ്റേ അവേ ഫ്രം ദാറ്റ് തിങ്. അപ്പോൾ ദിസ് ടൈപ്പ് ഓഫ് അസോസിയേറ്റീവ് ലേണിംഗ് ഹാപ്പൻസ്. ആൻഡ് ഇവിടെ വേറെ രണ്ട് കാര്യങ്ങൾ പറയാനുള്ളത്, അസോസിയേറ്റീവ് ലേണിംഗ് ഹാപ്പൻസ് ആൻഡ് അറ്റ് ദ സെയിം ടൈം strengthening of behavior. ഇത് രണ്ടും എന്താണെന്ന് മനസ്സിലായോ? അസോസിയേറ്റ് ചെയ്യാൻ തുടങ്ങി. ഞാൻ ആ റെഡ് സോറി ബ്ലൂ ബട്ടൺ പ്രസ് ചെയ്താൽ എനിക്ക് ഫുഡ് കിട്ടുള്ളൂ, അത് പതുക്കെ പഠിക്കാൻ തുടങ്ങി. അതേസമയത്ത് റെഡ് ബട്ടൺ പ്രസ് ചെയ്ത് കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ ഐ വിൽ റിസീവ് ദ ഷോക്ക്. ഇങ്ങനെ റാറ്റ് പഠിക്കാൻ തുടങ്ങി. സോ വി ക്യാൻ കോൾ ഇറ്റ് ആസ് എൻ അസോസിയേറ്റീവ് ലേണിംഗ്. ഇറ്റ് സ്റ്റാർട്ട് അസോസിയേറ്റിംഗ്. ദെൻ അറ്റ് ദ സെയിം ടൈം സ്ട്രെങ്തനിങ് ഓഫ് ബിഹേവിയർ ഓൾസോ ഹാപ്പൻ. എന്താണ് സ്ട്രെങ്തനിങ് ഓഫ് ബിഹേവിയർ? ബ്ലൂ ബട്ടൺ പ്രസ് ചെയ്ത് കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ ഐ വിൽ റിസീവ് ദ ഫുഡ് പെല്ലറ്റ്. അപ്പൊ ആ ഒരു ബിഹേവിയർ, ആ റെഡ് ബ്ലൂ ബട്ടൺ പ്രസ് ചെയ്യാനുള്ള ആ ഒരു ബിഹേവിയർ അവിടെ പതുക്കെ സ്ട്രെങ്തൻ ചെയ്തു. സോ വി ക്യാൻ സേ ദാറ്റ് ഓപ്പറൻ കണ്ടീഷനിങ് ഇറ്റ്സ് എ ടൈപ്പ് ഓഫ് അസോസിയേറ്റീവ് ലേണിംഗ്. ആൻഡ് ഓൾസോ വി ക്യാൻ സേ ദാറ്റ് സ്ട്രെങ്തനിങ് ഓഫ് ബിഹേവിയർ ഹാപ്പൻസ് ഹിയർ. That means the reward, and it is modified by certain types of reinforcement. Appa I hope the experiment is clear to you. And in this experiment, reinforcement and punishment takes place. These are the two important terms associated with operant conditioning. So what is that? Reinforcement and punishment. So in this experiment, what is the reinforcer? What is the reinforcer?
Food.
Yes, food is the reinforcer. And then what is the punishment? Punishment in the paranada, that is the electric shock. So we can say that operant conditioning, it is a type of associative learning process. It's better you just write down. This is an important sentence, important point. You please write it down. Operant conditioning. is a type of associative learning process through which the strength of a behavior is modified by reinforcement or punishment. So operant conditioning, it is a type of associative learning process. It's a learning process, and this occurs, or this process through which the strength of a behavior is modified by reinforcement or punishment. And we can say that this operant conditioning, it is also referred to as instrumental conditioning. ഇൻസ്ട്രുമെന്റൽ കണ്ടീഷനിങ് എന്ന് വേറൊരു പേരുണ്ട് ഓപ്പറന്റ് കണ്ടീഷനിങ് ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് ഓൾസോ കോൾഡ് ദ ഇൻസ്ട്രുമെന്റൽ കണ്ടീഷനിങ് Thus, we can say that it is a method of learning that occurs through rewards and punishment for behavior. For a particular behavior strengthen cheyanundengil adu it is associated with the reward as well as punishment. Adana ee operant conditionally parayana. Then when we talk about the components of operant conditioning, what are the components? Reinforcement and punishment, they are considered as the main components of operant conditioning. Then what is called a reinforcement? Any next is reinforcement. What is reinforcement? So inside
giving reward,
giving
any kind of stimuli which improve
which strengthens or increases. Yes, that is called the reinforcement. So reinforcement, if you want ഞാൻ വേണമെങ്കിൽ നിങ്ങൾക്ക് നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ആവശ്യം ഉണ്ടെന്നുണ്ടെങ്കിൽ ചെറുതായിട്ട് മീൻസ് നോട്ട്സ് തരാൻ ഐ വിൽ ഡിക്റ്റേറ്റ് ഇറ്റ് യു ക്യാൻ റൈറ്റ് ഇറ്റ് ഡൗൺ വെച്ചാൽ ഈസി ആയിട്ട് മനസ്സിലാകാൻ വേണ്ടി ഇഫ് യു വോണ്ട് സോ റീഎൻഫോഴ്സ്മെന്റ് ഇഫ് യു യു നീഡ് ദ ഡെഫിനിഷൻ ഫോർ റീഎൻഫോഴ്സ്മെന്റ് സിമ്പിൾ ഡെഫിനിഷൻ
Yes,
then write it down. Reinforcement is any stimulus that strengthens or increases the probability of a specific response. അപ്പൊ ഈ ഒരു ഡെഫിനിഷൻ വായിച്ചാൽ വോട്ട് ഈസ് റീഇൻഫോഴ്സ്മെന്റ് എന്ന് മനസ്സിലാവും. ഇതിപ്പോ ഞാൻ പറയാൻ കാര്യം എന്താന്ന് വെച്ച് കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ ഈ റീഇൻഫോഴ്സ്മെന്റും പണിഷ്മെന്റും ഒക്കെ വരുമ്പോഴത്തേക്കും കുറച്ച് കൺഫ്യൂഷൻ ഉണ്ടാകാനായിട്ട് ചാൻസസ് ഉണ്ട്. അത് താഴേക്ക് വരുമ്പോ മനസ്സിലാവും. അപ്പോ ദിസ് ഇസ് റീഇൻഫോഴ്സ്മെന്റ് ഇസ് എനിത്തിങ് ദാറ്റ് സ്ട്രെങ്തൻസ് ഓർ ഇൻക്രീസസ് ദ പ്രോബബിലിറ്റി ഓഫ് എ പെർട്ടിക്കുലർ ബിഹേവിയർ. ആൻഡ് വെൻ വി ടോക്ക് അബൌട്ട് റീഇൻഫോഴ്സ്മെന്റ് ദർ ആർ ടു ടൈപ്സ് ഓഫ് റീഇൻഫോഴ്സ്മെന്റ്. വൺ ഇസ് പോസിറ്റീവ് റീഇൻഫോഴ്സ്മെന്റ് ആൻഡ് ദ അതർ ഇസ് നെഗറ്റീവ് റീഇൻഫോഴ്സ്മെന്റ്. വൺ ഇസ് പോസിറ്റീവ് റീഇൻഫോഴ്സ്മെന്റ് ആൻഡ് അതർ ഇസ് നെഗറ്റീവ് റീഇൻഫോഴ്സ്മെന്റ്. ദെൻ നൗ ലെറ്റ് അസ് ലുക്ക് വാട്ട് ആർ പോസിറ്റീവ് റീഇൻഫോഴ്സ്മെന്റ്. Positive reinforcement means, write down, positive reinforcers are favorable events or outcomes that are presented after the behavior. Appa positive reinforcement nu parna endana, that are favorable events or outcomes that are presented after the behavior. That means for example, if you do a good job at your workplace, then your manager gives you a bonus. That is an example for പോസിറ്റീവ് റീഇൻഫോഴ്സസ്. അപ്പൊ നിങ്ങൾ നിങ്ങളുടെ ജോലി സ്ഥലത്ത് നന്നായിട്ടൊന്ന് വർക്ക് ചെയ്തു, നല്ലൊരു പെർഫോമൻസ് കാഴ്ചവെച്ചു, ദെൻ വാട്ട് ഹാപ്പൻസ്? ദ മാനേജർ റെക്കഗ്നൈസസ് ദാറ്റ് യുവർ വർക്ക് ആൻഡ് ഹി ഗീവ്സ് യു എ ബോണസ്. സോ ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് എ പോസിറ്റീവ് റീഇൻഫോഴ്സ്മെന്റ്. അപ്പൊ ദാറ്റ് എക്സാമ്പിൾ ഓൾസോ യു പ്ലീസ് നോട്ട് ഇറ്റ് ഡൗൺ, അതർവൈസ് യു വിൽ ബിക്കം കൺഫ്യൂസ്ഡ്. അപ്പൊ പോസിറ്റീവ് റീഇൻഫോഴ്സസ് എന്ന് വെച്ചാൽ എന്താണ്? ദേ ആർ ദ ഫേവറബിൾ ഇവന്റ്സ് ഓർ ഔട്ട്കം ദാറ്റ് ആർ പ്രസന്റഡ് ആഫ്റ്റർ ദ ബിഹേവിയർ. അപ്പൊ ഈ ആഫ്റ്റർ ദ ബിഹേവിയർ, അപ്പൊ ഇവിടെ പെർട്ടിക്കുലർ ബിഹേവിയർ എന്താണ്? നല്ല രീതിയിൽ നിങ്ങൾ വർക്ക് ചെയ്തു, അപ്പൊ എന്താണ് മാനേജർ അത് ഒരു കൺസിഡർ ചെയ്തിട്ട് ഹി ഈസ് ഗിവിങ് യു എ ബോണസ്. സോ ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് എ പോസിറ്റീവ് റീഇൻഫോഴ്സ്മെന്റ്. ദെൻ കമ്മിങ് ടു നെഗറ്റീവ് റീഇൻഫോഴ്സ്മെന്റ്, യു പ്ലീസ് റൈറ്റ് ഡൗൺ negative reinforcement. Here a response or behavior is strengthened by stopping removing or avoiding or avoiding a negative outcome, a negative outcome, or aversive stimuli, a negative outcome or aversive stimuli. So here what happens? A particular behavior is strengthened by stopping or removing or avoiding a negative outcome or aversive stimuli. I'll give you an example. Removing restrictions from a child when she follows the rule is an example of negative reinforcement. അപ്പോൾ ഒരു കുട്ടി ഇപ്പോൾ എന്തെങ്കിലും ഒരു അൺഡിസൈറബിൾ ആയിട്ട് എന്തെങ്കിലും ഒരു ബിഹേവിയർ എക്സിബിറ്റ് ചെയ്യാണ്. അപ്പോൾ അതിന് അപ്പോൾ ഫോർ എക്സാമ്പിൾ എല്ലാ ദിവസവും സ്കൂളിൽ പോകാൻ നേരത്ത് കരയുകയാണ്. കരയുന്ന കാരണം കുട്ടിയുടെ മദർ പറയാണ് എല്ലാ ദിവസവും രാവിലെ സ്കൂളിൽ പോകാൻ നേരത്ത് കരയുന്ന കാരണം എന്താണ്? വൈകുന്നേരം വന്നു കഴിഞ്ഞിട്ട് ഇനി തൊട്ട് ഞാൻ ടി വി കാണിക്കില്ല. അങ്ങനെ ഒരു ഒരു പണിഷ്മെന്റ് അവിടെ കൊടുക്കുകയാണ്. പക്ഷെ കുറച്ച് ദിവസം കഴിഞ്ഞ് കഴിഞ്ഞപ്പോ കുട്ടി കരയണു. അപ്പൊ കുട്ടിക്ക് മനസ്സിലായി ഞാൻ കരയണ കാരണം എന്നെ അതിവിടെ ടി വി കാണിക്കാൻ സമ്മതിക്കില്ല വൈകുന്നേരം വന്നു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ. അത് കഴിഞ്ഞ് ഗ്രാജുവലി ഈ കുട്ടി പഠിക്കുകയാണ്. ഇനി കരഞ്ഞിട്ട് ഒരു രക്ഷയില്ല. അത് കാരണം കുട്ടി കരച്ചിൽ പതുക്കെ നിർത്തി. അപ്പൊ എന്താണ്, ആ റെസ്ട്രിക്ഷൻ, ആ ടി വി കാണിക്കില്ല എന്നുള്ള ആ ഒരു റെസ്ട്രിക്ഷൻ അങ്ങ് മാറ്റുകയാണ് ചെയ്യുന്നത്. സോ ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് വി കോൾ ദാറ്റ് ടൈപ്പ് ഓഫ് reinforcer we call as a negative reinforcer. Appa here endana, her response or behavior is strengthened by stopping or avoiding a negative outcome or aversive stimuli. Is it clear? So you can write down the example. Removing restrictions from a child, removing restrictions from a child when she follows the rule, and she follows the rule is an example of negative reinforcement. So we can say that when we go through the positive reinforcers and negative reinforcement behavior increases. Reinforcement behavior, it is gradually increasing. So when we talk about the reinforcer, what do you mean by a reinforcer? Reinforcement means any stimulus that strengthens or increases the probability of a specific response. And there are two different types of reinforcers. The one is positive reinforcer and the other is the negative reinforcer. So what is positive reinforcer? Positive reinforcer means positive reinforcers are any favorable events or outcomes that are presented after the behavior. അപ്പൊ അതിന് നിങ്ങൾ ഇത് ഓരോന്ന് പഠിക്കുമ്പോഴും ജസ്റ്റ് കീപ്പ് ഇൻ യുവർ മൈൻഡ് ദാറ്റ് എക്സാമ്പിൾ. സോ ഇഫ് യു ഡു എ ഗുഡ് ജോബ് അറ്റ് യുവർ വർക്ക് പ്ലേസ്, യുവർ മാനേജർ ഗീവ്സ് യുവർ ബോണസ്. ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് എൻ എക്സാമ്പിൾ ഫോർ പോസിറ്റീവ് റീഇൻഫോഴ്സർ. ദെൻ വെൻ വി ടോക്ക് അബൌട്ട് ദ നെഗറ്റീവ് റീഇൻഫോഴ്സർ, ഹിയർ വാട്ട് ഹാപ്പൻസ്? ദ റെസ്പോൺസ് ഓർ എ പെർട്ടിക്കുലർ ബിഹേവിയർ, ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് സ്ട്രെങ്തൻഡ് by stopping or sometimes removing or by avoiding a negative outcome or aversive stimuli. That means removing restrictions from a child when she follows the rule is an example of negative reinforcement. Then next is hope it is clear. Reinforcement, is it clear? ഇത് നിങ്ങൾ ആ ടെക്സ്റ്റ് ബുക്കിൽ നോക്കി കഴിഞ്ഞു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ ഒത്തിരി എക്സാമ്പിൾസ്, അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഗൂഗിൾ ഗൂഗിൾ ചെയ്ത് കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ ഒത്തിരി എക്സാമ്പിൾസ് കാണും. സോ ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് ഈസി. ആ എക്സാമ്പിളിൽ കൂടി പോയി കഴിഞ്ഞു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ ദ ഡെഫിനിഷൻ ഇറ്റ് വിൽ ബി മോർ ഈസി. ദെൻ നെക്സ്റ്റ് ഇസ് ഷാൽ ഐ മൂവ് ടു ദ നെക്സ്റ്റ് പണിഷ്മെന്റ്. നെക്സ്റ്റ് ഇസ് പണിഷ്മെന്റ്. വെൻ വി ടോക്ക് അബൌട്ട് ദ പണിഷ്മെന്റ്, ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് എ വെരി കോമൺലി യൂസ്ഡ് ടേം. വാട്ട് ഇസ് പണിഷ്മെന്റ്? പണിഷ്മെന്റ് ഇസ് ദ, യു കെൻ റൈറ്റ് ദ ഡെഫിനിഷൻ, പണിഷ്മെന്റ് ഇസ് ദ presentation of an adverse event or outcome, adverse event or outcome that causes a decrease in the behavior, that causes a decrease in the behavior. അപ്പോൾ പോസിറ്റീവ് സോറി റീഇൻഫോഴ്സേഴ്സിൽ എപ്പോഴും പോസിറ്റീവ് വെദർ ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് പോസിറ്റീവ് റീഇൻഫോഴ്സർ ഓർ നെഗറ്റീവ് റീഇൻഫോഴ്സർ ഇൻ ബോത്ത് കേസസ് ദ റീഇൻഫോഴ്സ്മെന്റ് ബിഹേവിയർ ഇൻക്രീസസ് ബട്ട് വെൻ വി ടോക്ക് അബൌട്ട് ദ പണിഷ്മെന്റ് ഹിയർ വാട്ട് ഹാപ്പൻസ് ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് ദ പ്രസന്റേഷൻ ഓഫ് ആൻ അഡ്വേഴ്സ് ഇവന്റ് ഓർ ഔട്ട്കം that causes a decrease in behavior. And similarly, just like a reinforces also, positive reinforcement, sorry, positive punishment is the, negative punishment is the. So write down that there are different types of punishment. First is positive punishment and the other is negative punishment. So now let us look at positive punishment. Positive punishment is decreasing the rate of any undesired behavior from an individual. ഒരു പെർട്ടിക്കുലർ അൺഡിസൈറബിൾ ആയിട്ടുള്ള ഇഫ് സം അൺഡിസൈറബിൾ ബിഹേവിയർ ഇസ് ദ വി ആർ ട്രൈങ് ടു റിമൂവ് ദാറ്റ് ബിഹേവിയർ ഓർ ട്രൈങ് ടു ഡിക്രീസ് ദാറ്റ് പെർട്ടിക്കുലർ ബിഹേവിയർ ഫോർ എക്സാമ്പിൾ സ്ലാപ്പിംഗ് എ ചൈൽഡ് വെൻ ദ ചൈൽഡ് ത്രോസ് എ ടാൻട്രം ഇപ്പൊ ഭയങ്കര ശബ്ദം ഉണ്ടാക്കി ബഹളം ഉണ്ടാക്കി കരയുകയാണെന്നുണ്ടെങ്കിൽ ഒരു അടി കൊടുക്കുകയാണെങ്കിൽ ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് എ പോസിറ്റീവ് റീഇൻഫോഴ്സ്മെന്റ് സോറി പോസിറ്റീവ് പണിഷ്മെന്റ് അപ്പോ പോസിറ്റീവ് പണിഷ്മെന്റ് ഈസ് ഡിക്രീസിംഗ് ദ റേറ്റ് ഓഫ് എനി അൺഡിസയേർഡ് ബിഹേവിയർ ഫ്രം ആൻ ഇൻഡിവിജ്വൽ ഹിയർ ഓൾസോ പ്രസന്റിംഗ് എ നെഗറ്റീവ് കോൺസിക്വൻസ് ആഫ്റ്റർ ആൻ അൺഡിസയേർഡ് ബിഹേവിയർ അപ്പൊ പ്രസന്റിംഗ് എ നെഗറ്റീവ് കോൺസിക്വൻസ് ഓർ ഗിവിംഗ് എ നെഗറ്റീവ് കോൺസിക്വൻസ് ആഫ്റ്റർ an undesired behavior. For example also you can write down slapping a child when the child shows or throws a tantrum, tantrum, when the child throws a tantrum. So that is an example for positive punishment. The next is negative punishment. Negative punishment focuses on decreasing the rate of any undesired behavior from an individual. ഇപ്പൊ വെൻ യു ഗോ ത്രൂ ദ ഡെഫിനിഷൻ ഓഫ് പോസിറ്റീവ് പണിഷ്മെന്റ് ആൻഡ് നെഗറ്റീവ് പണിഷ്മെന്റ് സീംസ് സെയിം ബട്ട് ദർ ഇസ് സ്ലൈറ്റ് ഡിഫറൻസ് നെഗറ്റീവ് പണിഷ്മെന്റ് മീൻസ് ഇറ്റ് ഫോക്കസസ് ഓൺ ഡിക്രീസിംഗ് ദ റേറ്റ് ഓഫ് എനി അൺഡിസയേർഡ് ബിഹേവിയർ ഫ്രം ആൻ ഇൻഡിവിജ്വൽ ഫോർ എക്സാമ്പിൾ സംതിങ് ഗുഡ് ഈസ് ടേക്കൺ എവേ ദറ്റ് ഇസ് ഓൾസോ യു ക്യാൻ റൈറ്റ് ഡൗൺ സംതിങ് ഗുഡ് is being taken away as a result of the individual's undesired behavior. For example, you can write this example, taking away a child's video game video game following misbehavior. This usually happens in our home. നമ്മളിപ്പോ കുട്ടികള് എക്സാമിന് മാർക്ക് കുറഞ്ഞു, ഉടനെ നമ്മൾ എന്താ ചെയ്യുന്നത്, ഇനിയും ടി വി കാണിക്കില്ല, അല്ലെങ്കിൽ മൊബൈല് തരില്ല. ഇങ്ങനത്തെ വി മേക്ക് സോ മെനി റെസ്ട്രിക്ഷൻസ്. സോ ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് എ നെഗറ്റീവ് പണിഷ്മെന്റ് ബിക്കോസ് ദ ചൈൽഡ് സ്കോർഡ് ലെസ് മാർക്ക് ഇൻ ദ എക്സാം ആൻഡ് ഫോളോയിങ് ദാറ്റ് വാട്ട് ഹാപ്പൻസ്, വാട്ട് വിൽ ബി വാട്ട് ദ പേരൻസ് യൂഷ്വലി ഡു, ദേ റെസ്ട്രിക്ട് സെർട്ടൻ തിങ്സ്. So that is a negative punishment. So these are the different types of punishment. So first is when we talk about the operant conditioning, what are the things mainly you have to study the rewards and punishment, what is the association, how the association is formed. And we can say that when we talk about the theories of personality, this in this way our behavior, certain types of behavior are strengthened in a person, and this definitely we know that it affects the personality. So this is all about the personality, that is about the rewards and punishment. Is it clear? You please go through the notes.
Yes.
Okay. Then one more theory is there, that is called the law of effect. Law of effect. So law of effect, who? This the Skinner's theory, it is called the operant conditioning.
Neil Thorndike.
Operant conditioning, Skinner ndana. Any law of effect, it is by Thorndike. This is also very important. Thorndike. What is that law? Any idea? Any idea about that law? Law of effect. The law of effect, it was first proposed by Thorndike. The full name is Edward Thorndike, and Thorndike suggested that if a situation is followed by satisfaction, then there are more chances to reoccur that behavior. Mansilayo? If a situation is followed by satisfaction, so when we perform a certain type of behavior, and definitely some consequence will be there, and if the consequence is very pleasant or favorable, then what happens? Then there are more chances to reoccur that behavior. We all know that. Ipo suppose if we touch a hot object, suddenly we withdraw our hand. Why? Because touching a hot object means it is not a pleasant thing, it is slightly painful. So what happens? So we want there are less chances to reoccur that particular behavior, that means touching a hot object. But on the other hand, if a situation is followed by discomfort, that is what I mentioned, that is if a situation is followed by discomfort, the connections to the situation will become weaker, and the behavior of response is less likely to occur when the situation is repeated. So these two points you can write down. Law of effect, the first point. Are you writing?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, right. Please note down.
Yes, ma'am.
If a situation is followed by satisfaction, comma, then then there are more chances, then there are more chances to reoccur, that behavior. Next point, if the situation is followed by discomfort, the connections to the situations will become weaker, and the behavior or response is less likely to occur when the situation is repeated. Then I'll give you an example. Suppose if an employee arrived early to work for one day by accidentally he came early in the office, then the boss notices and praises his diligence. Okay, so this praise make the employee to feel good and it reinforces the behavior and he start coming to work early. മനസ്സിലായി? അപ്പോൾ ഒരു ഒരാള് ഒരു ബൈ ആക്സിഡൻ്റലി നേരത്തെ ഓഫീസിൽ വന്നു ആൻഡ് ദ ബോസ് നോട്ടീസസ് ഇറ്റ് ആൻഡ് ഹി മേക്സ് എ പ്രൈസ് ഫോർ ഹിസ് ഡിലിജൻസ്. അപ്പൊ എന്താണ് സംഭവിക്കുന്നത്? ദിസ് പ്രൈസ് മേക്സ് ദ എംപ്ലോയി ഫീൽ ഗുഡ് ആൻഡ് ഇറ്റ് ആക്ട് ആസ് എ റീഇൻഫോഴ്സർ ഫോർ ദാറ്റ് പെർട്ടിക്കുലർ ബിഹേവിയർ. ഏത് ബിഹേവിയറിനാണ്? എല്ലാ ദിവസവും നേരത്തെ വരിക എന്നുള്ള ആ ഒരു ബിഹേവിയറിന് ഇറ്റ് ആക്ട്സ് ആസ് എ ദിസ് ദ പ്രൈസ് ഓഫ് ദി എംപ്ലോയർ ആക്ട്സ് ആസ് എ റീഇൻഫോഴ്സർ ആൻഡ് ദിസ് ഹി സ്റ്റാർട്ട് കമ്മിങ് ടു വർക്ക് ഏർലി എവറി ഡേ. ദറ്റ് ഈസ് വൺ എക്സാമ്പിൾ. ദെൻ ദ നെക്സ്റ്റ് എക്സാമ്പിൾ ഇസ് സപ്പോസ് വെൻ യു റൈഡ് എ ബൈക്ക് ആൻഡ് യു ഡിസൊബേ ദ ട്രാഫിക് റൂൾ and if you receive a penalty, then what will be your behavior? Then you will be less likely to disobey the traffic rules in the future. Ipa bike odichu povana, helmet is compulsory nowadays. Appo suppose if you're not wearing the helmet, avade vachu traffic police pidichu, fine adachu, penalty kodukandi vannu, pinna next time povumba endayalum you won't forget to take the helmet. Adana then that means here the behavior it is then you will be less likely to disobey the traffic rules in the future. Appa aa oru behavior la change varuvana cheynadu. So adana rendu points ipo njan parnille. First is if the situation is followed by satisfaction, then there are more chances to reoccur. Appa oru particular situation, that is coming to the office early, that and the employee gets praise from the boss, that is followed by satisfaction. Appo nerthe vannu, that is followed by satisfaction, means he gets the praise. So then there are more chances to reoccur that behavior. But in the second situation, what happens? It is followed by discomfort. So you are traveling without wearing a helmet, then what happens? Then you get a penalty. Then appo pinne what will be the consequence? Then the situation you try or that particular behavior or response is less likely to occur. You won't repeat that. So that is called the law of effect. So here also some connections happen between the situation and the behavior. Some connections are happening between the situations and the behavior. Similarly, just like Skinner and Pavlov also, Thorndike also conducted various experiments, and one experiment, the famous experiment, he used the puzzle box. It was used by whom? Thorndike. And this puzzle box, it consists of a small lever inside. So these levers, 1 minute. So these levers, when pressed, would allow the animal to escape. അപ്പൊ ഇതിനകത്ത് ഈ പസിൽ ബോക്സിൽ ജസ്റ്റ് ലൈക്ക് സ്കിന്നർ ബോക്സ് ദർ വാസ് ടു ബട്ടൺസ് ബ്ലൂ ബട്ടൺ ആൻഡ് റെഡ് ബട്ടൺ ബട്ട് ഇൻ ദ പസിൽ ബോക്സ് ബൈ തോണ്ടെക് ദർ ആർ സ്മോൾ ലീവേഴ്സ് ഇൻസൈഡ് ദ പസിൽ ബോക്സ് അപ്പൊ വെൻ ദ ആൻഡ് ഹി യൂസ്ഡ് കാറ്റ് for his experiment and Tontek placed a cat inside the puzzle box and then placed a piece of meat outside the box manslayo appo puzzle box il lever und and he used the cat for his experiment initially he placed the cat inside the puzzle box and after that endana he placed a piece of meat outside the box and he observed the cat's efforts to escape and obtain food appo oru hungry aayittulla oru cat ne puzzle box il ittu ennittu koodinte porathana ee meat vechathu appo ennittu he observed the cat's effort to escape from the box and escape from the box at the same time the cat also tried to obtain the food and he recorded how long each animal took it free how long each animal takes the time to free itself from the box or animal etra time porthake povanayittu edukkunnallathu he observed in between eventually the cat happened to press the lever and the door opened and it could receive the reward what is the reward meat is the reward by accidentally the cat presses the lever and what happened the door opened and the cat it went outside and he could also receive the reward even though the first pressing the pressing of the lever it occurred simply by accident the cat became likely to repeat it because they had received reward immediately after performing the action okay some connectionism happens here so the Thorndyke observed that with each trial the cat become much faster in opening the door and this happens because while pressing the lever the cat receives the reward what is the reward meat and which is a favorable outcome and this makes the cat to repeat the behavior and idana experiment appo puzzle box inde ullile it contains few levers and the cat was placed inside the puzzle box and accidentally when the cat presses the lever what happened the door opened so that it can go outside and it could get the meat then pinne idu pala thavana repeat cheyina samayath endana gradually that learning of a particular behavior happens and the cat also start associating some connectionism happens here what is that connectionism because when if the cat learned that if it presses the lever the door will open so that it could be able to go outside and at the same time it will get the food so this happens because so here also the strengthening of that particular behavior happens because what is the outcome it was a favorable outcome and this because of this favorable outcome what happens this makes the cat to repeat that particular behavior and Thorndyke termed this as law of effect and here he suggested that when satisfaction follows an association it is more likely to be repeated so I gave you two points in the beginning of this law of effect that is first is what is the first one
it is a situation is followed by satisfaction then there are no chance to reoccur that behavior
so he in this way with this experiment he proved the that both two statements is it clear but on the other hand if an unfavorable outcome follows an action then it becomes less likely to be repeated. So the two key aspects of law of effect, that is behavior immediately followed by favorable consequences, are more likely to occur again, and other is the behavior followed by unfavorable consequences are less likely to occur again. Okay, is it clear? So this is called the law of effect. Then I had gone through the observational learning, no? Do you remember? Observational learning padipichallayirunno. Did I? Observer. No. So observational, what is observational learning? Observational learning means it is the type of learning that occurs through observing the behavior of others. And we can say that it is a form of social learning. It comes under social learning. I think I had already taken this observational.
Yes, ma'am.
By Albert Bandura.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, already.
Yes, yes, ma'am.
So what are the processes involved in observational learning?
Watching.
Then after that, we are retaining the observation and we try to replicate the behavior that were observed. So these are the process and observational learning. It is also called the modeling, or what are the other names? Vicarious learning, shaping, observational learning. Names like Kadarim, and it was proposed by Albert Bandura. Okay, so next we will move to the other theory. Then Karen Horney's theory. So shall we take, I need a 2-3 minutes break. My throat is getting dry. Okay, so yes, shall we start at 11 o'clock?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Hello, shall we start?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Next. It is about the Karen Horney's theory of neurotic needs, or the Karen Horney's theory of personality. We can say that the Karen Horney's theory of personality. And actually this theory, Karen Horney. H-O-R. or N-E-Y. Hmm? So it is N-E-Y-E, Karen Horney. Okay, it is pronounced as Karen Horney. So Karen Horney's theory of personality, and we know that Karen Horney, she was a neo-Freudian psychologist. Neo-Freudian psychologist. What is the Freud's theory of psychology? Freud's theory. What is the Freud's theory of psychology? നമ്മള് പേഴ്സണാലിറ്റിയിൽ പഠിച്ചാണല്ലോ. വാട്ട് ദാറ്റ് സൈക്കോ ഫ്രോയിഡ്സ് തിയറി സൈക്കോ അനലിറ്റിക് തിയറി. വാട്ട് ആർ ദ കമ്പോണൻസ് ഓഫ് സൈക്കോ അനലിറ്റിക് തിയറി? ത്രീ കമ്പോണൻസ്: ഇഡ്, ഈഗോ, സൂപ്പർ ഈഗോ. ദെൻ വാട്ട് ആർ ദ ഡിഫറെന്റ് സ്റ്റേജസ് ഓഫ് സൈക്കോ അനലിറ്റിക് തിയറി? Do you remember that ഈ തിയറിനെ കുറച്ച്, ആ ഫ്രോയിഡിന്റെ തിയറിനെ ഒപ്പോസ് ചെയ്ത കുറച്ച് സൈക്കോളജിസ്റ്റ് ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നു. സോ ദേ ആർ കോൾഡ് ദ നിയോ ഫ്രോയിഡിയൻ സൈക്കോളജിസ്റ്റ്. സോ കാരൻ ഹോണി, ഷീ വാസ് എ നിയോ ഫ്രോയിഡിയൻ സൈക്കോളജിസ്റ്റ്. And she is known for her theory of neurotic needs. She is known for her theory of neurotic needs. And she has done in-depth research in feminine psychology also. She said, Karen Horney is another lady, and she has done in-depth research in the feminine psychology. And she made some important contribution to self-psychology. That is, she emphasized the role of self-analysis and self-help play in mental health. Anyway, we can consider her theory as a critic of Freud's theory. She is the main critic of Freud. She gave more importance to the neurotic needs. Then she made some contribution to self-psychology. What is self-psychology? In the sense that she focused on the role of self-analysis as well as self-help in the how self-help play an important role in mental health. That was the main focus of her study. So her theory is best known for neurotic needs. That is best known for her theories of neurosis, and she believed neurosis result from basic anxiety caused by interpersonal relationship. So she had stressed, or she had given more importance to the basic needs. 1 minute. So she had given importance to neurosis. What is neurosis? Neurosis ariyalo. What are the features of a neurotic person? What are the features of a neurotic person?
Anxiety,
always worrying, tensed. Then usually pessimism,
impulsive
behavior, insecure feeling. All these are the features or the characteristic features of a neurotic person. And Karen Horney, she believed that the neurosis, it results from basic anxiety. It happens or it resulted from basic anxiety. And basic anxiety, and this basic anxiety is caused by.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Some of us can't see your.
Presenting, ma'am. Not able to see the slides.
Not able to see the slides. Now.
No,
can you see it now? No.
Ma'am, actually, it is visible.
No, ma'am.
Indo.
Actually, it is visible. They need to ping your screen.
We have only your one screen is there, not the presenting screen.
Go check for the almost who are there, and then check for the ma'ams. There are two this thing of ma'ams. So press the other one and then pin her.
We can see only one one of her this
one screen of her.
Is it a mistake from my side?
No, ma'am.
Okay.
For the people who have joined in there, there will be two names of ma'am. So press
yes,
the
ma'am.
Other
now
one.
I can, now I can see it.
All of you got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So she emphasized on neurosis, and she believed that the neurosis, it resulted from basic anxiety. And how this basic anxiety occur? This basic anxiety, it is caused by interpersonal relationship. So she in this theory, Karen Horney, in her theory of neurotechnics, she emphasized on neurosis. And according to her, this neurosis, it results from basic anxiety. And how this basic anxiety occur? This basic anxiety, it is caused by interpersonal relationship. Okay. It's caused by interpersonal relationship. So according to Horney, the basic anxiety could result from a variety of situations. So when we talk about the interpersonal relationship, we have to come across with various situations. So Karen Horney, she says that basic anxiety, it could result from a variety of situations. That it can be sometimes some direct relationship or some indirect relationship. For example, some erratic behavior from parents. We know that human beings, we all are social animals. So it is very necessary for us to interact with each and everyone around us. അല്ലെ, നമ്മളുടെ ചുറ്റും ഒത്തിരി ആൾക്കാരുണ്ട്. ഇവരൊക്കെ ആയിട്ട് നമുക്ക് ഡെയിലി ബേസിസിൽ നമുക്ക് ഒരു രീതിയിൽ അല്ലെങ്കിൽ വേറൊരു രീതിയിൽ വി ഹാവ് ടു ഇന്ററാക്ട്. ഇവിടെ ഇന്ററാക്ഷൻ എന്ന് പറയുമ്പോൾ കമ്മ്യൂണിക്കേഷൻ മാത്രമല്ല, വി ഹാവ് ടു കം അക്രോസ് വിത്ത് വേരിയസ് ടൈപ്സ് ഓഫ് ഡീലിങ്സ്. ആൻഡ് ഇഫ് എനി unhappiness or if some erratic behavior happens from the other side, no, it will affect the human behavior, or it will affect the condition of the human being. That is some erratic behavior or some lack of respect. And when we talk about the child, during the developmental phase of the child has to get emotional warmth, then care, love, all those things from the caregiver or from the, we can say that from the parents. If the lack of respect or some of the basic needs of the child are not satisfied, it creates some sort of anxiety in the child. Similarly, in the grown-up people also, certain types of erratic behavior, then or if continuous conflict in the family, അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഒരു ഫോൾട്ടി ഇൻ്റർപേഴ്സണൽ റിലേഷൻഷിപ്പ്, ഇറ്റ്സ് ബെറ്റർ ടു സേ ദ ഫോൾട്ടി ഇൻ്റർപേഴ്സണൽ റിലേഷൻഷിപ്പ് ഹാപ്പൻസ്, ദെൻ വാട്ട് ഹാപ്പൻസ്, ഇറ്റ് ലീഡ്സ് ടു ന്യൂറോസിസ് ഓർ ആൻസൈറ്റി. That is what Karen Horney emphasized in her theory. Then usually it might be some types of direct or indirect domination. Then indifference in the, I'm talking about the various factors of the interpersonal relationship. So the direct or indirect domination, then some sort of indifference, as I mentioned, erratic behavior, then lack of respect of the child for the child's needs, then lack of emotional warmth. That is very important. If that lacks, again, it may lead to anxiety. Then lack of guidance during the developmental phase, then too much parental conflict or disagreement, then in some cases the children are very overprotective by the parents, then again it may cause some sort of anxiety. Then some discrimination or sibling rivalry, all the, if such things happens in the interpersonal relationship, it may affect the personality of the individual. That means it will lead to these type of behavior which occur in the interpersonal relationship. It lead to the basic anxiety, and finally it leads to a neurotic behavior. And the Karen Horney, she identified 10 neurotic needs. how many 10 neurotic needs aanu identify cheyidathu, and these 10 neurotic needs are classified into three broad categories. These 10 neurotic needs are categorized into three broad categories. These are the three broad categories. So how many neurotic needs did Karen Horney identified?
10.
And she minimized or she classified it into three broad categories.
Okay.
So first is the need to move you towards others. So these terms are very important. Italics taken, these terms are very important. Needs that moves you towards others, needs that move you away from others, needs that move you against others. Here, towards, away, against others. These are very important. So now let us go through first one, that is need that move you towards others. Because of this need, the individual seek affirmation and acceptance from others. So it is a need. Here, Karen Horney, she identified the need. The need, it is very essential for the life. So because as this need is dominant, and or because of this need, the individual seek affirmation and acceptance from others. So, do you remember this? ഈ ഒരു ദിനത്ത് പഠിച്ചത് ഓർക്കണ്ടോ? ഹിയർ ഓൾസോ വി I mentioned about the basic needs. This is the basic need. Here also, in this here. Do you remember this need? Self-esteem, confidence, achievement, respect to others, as well as respect by others. So it is considered as a need. So similarly, in this theory also, Karen Horney, she identified the need that moves you towards other. Here she focused on the need the individual seek, that is the mainly the need like affirmation and acceptance from others. That is, people always exhibit a tendency to be needy as well as clingy. We always have a tendency to cling to others. They seek and approve, seek out approval and love. That is called the need that moves you towards others. Nammala baaki ullavarude adutheke move cheynad endinana, because we want to be a part in the community. Our social group ile we want to be a member of that particular group, and at the same time we are seeking affirmation as well as acceptance from others. That means we always exhibit a tendency to be a part of the group, and we often have a tendency to get accepted by others. Appa aga ore approval baaki ullarin ore approval, at the same time we try to seek approval as well as love from others. That is an important need. That is called the need that move you towards others. Towards is very important. Is it clear? Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
അപ്പോൾ നമ്മൾ ഒരു ഗ്രൂപ്പിലെ മെമ്പർ ആകണമെന്നുണ്ടെങ്കിൽ നമുക്ക് എപ്പോഴും അക്സെപ്റ്റൻസ് വേണം ആ ഗ്രൂപ്പിൽ നിന്ന്, ബാക്കിയുള്ളവർ റെക്കഗ്നൈസ് ചെയ്യണം. ആ ഒരു ഇതിന് വേണ്ടിയിട്ട് വി മൂവ് ടുവേർഡ്സ് അതേഴ്സ്. ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് കോൾഡ് ദ നീഡ് ദാറ്റ് മൂവ്സ് യു ടുവേർഡ്സ് അതേഴ്സ്. സോ ഹിയർ വാട്ട് ഈസ് ദ നീഡ്? നീഡ് എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ വി ആർ സീക്കിംഗ് ഫോർ അഫർമേഷൻ ആസ് വെൽ ആസ് അക്സെപ്റ്റൻസ്. വി വോണ്ട് ടു ബി എ മെമ്പർ ഓഫ് ദാറ്റ് പെർട്ടിക്കുലർ ഗ്രൂപ്പ്. ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് ദ നീഡ് മെൻഷൻഡ് ഹിയർ ഇൻ ദിസ് പെർട്ടിക്കുലർ ആസ്പെക്ട്. ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ദ നീഡ്സ് ദാറ്റ് മൂവ് യു ടുവേർഡ്സ് അതേഴ്സ്. ദെൻ നെക്സ്റ്റ് ഈസ് ദ നീഡ്സ് ദാറ്റ് മൂവ് യു അവേ ഫ്രം അതേഴ്സ്. എന്താണ്, വാട്ട് ആർ ദ നീഡ്സ് ദാറ്റ് മൂവ് യു അവേ ഫ്രം അതേഴ്സ്? ഹിയർ ഓൾസോ വി ഹാവ് ടു സേ the needs that move you away from others in the context of the neurotic needs. So this neurotic needs creates hostility and antisocial behavior. So these type of individuals are often described as called indifferent, aloof, etc. ഇപ്പം നമ്മൾ പറയാറുണ്ട് ഒരു ഇൻട്രോവേർട്ട്, ആ ഇൻട്രോവേർട്ടിന്റെ കുറേ ഒരു എക്സ്ട്രീം കേസിലേക്ക് പോയി കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ ദേ ആർ യൂഷ്വലി വിഡ്രോൺ ഫ്രം ദ സൊസൈറ്റി, ദേ ഡസിൻ ലൈക്ക് ടു ബി ആസ് എ പാർട്ട് ഓഫ് ദ ഗ്രൂപ്പ്, ദേ ഓൾവേസ് പ്രിഫർ ടു ബി എലോൺ. ഓക്കെ, സിമിലർലി വി ക്യാൻ സേ ദാറ്റ് ദീസ് ടൈപ്പ് ഓഫ് പീപ്പിൾ ദേ ആർ ഇൻഡിഫറെന്റ് ആൻഡ് ദേ ആർ ഡിസ്ക്രൈബ്ഡ് ആസ് കോൾഡ്. Called in the sense they are not that much active. So the neurotic need, this type of need creates hostility. Angane ullore edutha endanu chela create some sort of hostility as well as antisocial behavior. Appa ee oru characteristic ulla aalkar endanu they create some sort of hostility among others, and at the same time they have a tendency to exhibit some sort of antisocial behavior. So that is called the need that move away from others. Appa avarile hostility, they are little bit indifferent, they prefers to be sit alone, they doesn't want to be a member of a particular group. So what happens, these type of behavior creates hostility among others, and we can say that to some extent they exhibit some sort of antisocial behavior. So because of this reason, then we can say that the need that move you away from others. Appa ingane thoru preference varumba we have a tendency to move away from others. Okay, that is the second. Then the third is the need that move you against others. This need result in hostility at the same time, and a need to control other people. Here also hostility will be there, but at the same time they have a tendency or a need to control other people. Ivide tendency ennalladilum koodalayitte use cheyyunna term, that is need. They have a need to control other people, that means they are little bit dominant, and these people are described as difficult. It is very difficult to get along with these people, and at the same time they are domineering, they are dominant figures, and to some extent they are unkind. So these are the characteristics described by Karen Horney in the third type. They are hostility will be the they have a need to control other people. Thus these people can be described as difficult, domineering, and unkind. So these are the three needs identified by actually Karen Horney. She identified 10 neurotic needs, and these 10 neurotic needs are classified into three broad categories. These are the three broad categories, that needs that move you towards others, needs that move you away from others, and needs that move you against others. Then the Karen Horney's theory of neurotic needs, in her book on self-analysis, Horney outlined the 10 neurotic needs she had identified. The need for affection and approval. The neurotic need for a partner who will take over one's life. Then the neurotic need to restrict one's life within narrow borders. And the neurotic need for power. The neurotic need to exploit others. The neurotic need for prestige. The neurotic need for personal admiration. The neurotic need for personal achievement, neurotic need for self-sufficiency and independence, the neurotic need for perfection and unassailability. Pidanna nokka kata, just you please write it down. finished? Edika Rimbana, you just inform me.
I see, ma'am.
Okay. Above, it is said that this neurotic people often utilize two or more of these ways of coping and create. ഈ ഇതിനകത്ത് ഇപ്പോൾ ഒരു ന്യൂറോട്ടിക് മീൻസ് സാധാരണ ന്യൂറോട്ടിക് ആൾക്കാർ ഈ മൂന്ന് ഇതിനകത്ത് ഏതെങ്കിലും അറ്റ്ലീസ്റ്റ് രണ്ടെണ്ണെങ്കിലും യൂസ് ചെയ്യുന്നതാണ് പറയുന്നത്. സോ ബട്ട് എ വെൽ അഡ്ജസ്റ്റഡ് ഇൻഡിവിജ്വൽ യൂട്ടിലൈസ് ഓൾ ദ ത്രീ ഓഫ് ദ സ്ട്രാറ്റജീസ് ദറ്റ് ഈസ് ടുവേർഡ് എവേ ആൻഡ് എഗെയിൻസ്റ്റ് അതേഴ്സ്. ഇത് നമ്മൾ ജസ്റ്റ് ഒന്ന് നോക്കിക്കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ നമ്മൾ ഇതിനകത്തുള്ള എല്ലാത്തിലും ഒരു മിക്സ്ചറായിട്ടാണ് നമ്മൾ അഡ്ജസ്റ്റ്മെന്റ് നടത്തുന്നത് അല്ലേ. സോ വി ക്യാൻ സേ ദാറ്റ് എ വെൽ അഡ്ജസ്റ്റഡ് പേഴ്സൺ യൂട്ടിലൈസ് ഓൾ ദ ത്രീ ഓഫ് ദ സ്ട്രാറ്റജീസ് ലൈക് ടുവേർഡ്സ് എവേ ആൻഡ് എഗെയിൻസ്റ്റ് അതേഴ്സ്. ഫൈനലി ഷീ ഐഡന്റിഫൈഡ് ഇത് എന്താണെന്നൊന്ന് ടെക്സ്റ്റിലുണ്ട്, അതൊന്ന് വായിച്ചു നോക്കുക. അപ്പൊ ഇത് ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് ഈസി ഫോർ യു ടു അണ്ടർസ്റ്റാൻഡ്. ഓക്കെ, ദെൻ നെക്സ്റ്റ്. അപ്പൊ ഈ തിയറി ഞാനിത് ഇത്രേ പറയുന്നുള്ളൂ. ദിസ് ഇസ് നോട്ട് ദാറ്റ് മച്ച് ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻറ്റ്, ബട്ട് കാരൻ ഹോണി, ഷീ ഈസ് എ ഫെമിനിൻ സൈക്കോളജിസ്റ്റ്, സെൽഫ് അനാലിസിസ് ഓർ സെൽഫ് തിയറിക്കൊക്കെ ഒത്തിരി ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻസ് കൊടുത്തേക്കുന്നതാണ്. ആൻഡ് ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് അബൌട്ട് ദ ന്യൂറോട്ടിക് നീഡ്സ്. ഷീ ഈസ് നോൺ ഫോർ ഹർ തിയറി ഓഫ് ന്യൂറോട്ടിക് നീഡ്സ് ആൻഡ് ഷീ ഹാസ് ഡൺ ഇൻ ഡെപ്ത് റിസർച്ച് ഇൻ ദ ഫെമിനിൻ സൈക്കോളജി, ദെൻ സെൽഫ് സൈക്കോളജി. ദാറ്റ് മീൻസ് ഷീ എംഫസൈസ് ദ റോൾ ഓഫ് സെൽഫ് അനാലിസിസ് ആസ് വെൽ ആസ് സെൽഫ് ഹെൽപ്പ്. And she is considered as a neo-Freudian psychologist. Okay. And the essence of this theory is that the Karen Horney believed neurosis resulted from basic anxiety caused by the what? Caused by interpersonal relationship. Okay. Then one more theory is that is Harry Stack Sullivan. It is a theory by Harry Stack Sullivan, and this theory, it is based on the people's interaction with others. That the interpersonal relationship in an importance kodutha, this is based on the people's interaction with other people. That is people interaction with other, especially significant people in their life. Who are considered as the significant members of the significant members in the family or the significant people in the life?
Yes.
Who is considered as the significant people in the life?
Parents.
Wife, husband, children, in-laws. These people are considered as the significant people in our life, and the our interaction or the people's interaction with other, especially with significant people in their life, that determines the sense of security, at the same time sense of self in them. Okay, appa aa baaki significant members aayittulla interaction, it will determine the sense of security at the same time sense of self. So these factors motivate the behavior. So you can write it down. That is, this theory is based, please write this sentence, this theory is based on the people's interaction with other. interaction with other people. That is people's interaction with others, especially especially significant people, especially significant people in their life, significant people in their life determines the sense of security, the sense of security, sense of self, sense of security and sense of self. So these factors motivates their behavior. The core thing is that the personality, it is shaped from our relationship with others or interaction with others. That is what Harry Stack Sullivan says. That is, personality cannot be separated from our social world. We are social beings. Namukku baakiyullavarayittulla interactions la that plays a very important role. So he says that the personality of a person, he cannot be separated from our social world. Nammala social world aayittu maatti nirthi kaiyna, we can't say anything about the personality. And according to Harry Stack Sullivan, tension, that plays a very important role. She mentioned a lot about in his theory, that is about the tension. So suppose, according to him, tensions means that it creates a biological imbalance between the person and the physicochemical environment. Okay, but tension varumbo it creates a biological impact between the person and the physicochemical environment. What is physicochemical environment? That is both inside and outside the individual. ഇപ്പൊ നമുക്ക് ഒരു ഇന്ററാക്ഷനിൽ, സോഷ്യൽ ഇന്ററാക്ഷനിൽ ഒരു ടെൻഷൻസ് വരുന്ന സമയത്ത് സം ബയോളജിക്കൽ ഇംബാലൻസ് വിൽ ഒക്കർ ഇൻസൈഡ് അവർ ബോഡി. സോ വി ക്യാൻ സേ ദാറ്റ് ഇൻസൈഡ് ആൻഡ് ഔട്ട്സൈഡ് ദ ഇൻഡിവിജ്വൽ സം ഇംബാലൻസ് വിൽ ബി ദർ. ഫോർ എക്സാമ്പിൾ ആൻസൈറ്റി. ഇപ്പൊ ആൻസൈറ്റി വരുന്ന സമയത്ത് സ്വാഭാവികമായിട്ട് ഹോർമോണൽ ചേഞ്ച് വിൽ ബി ദർ. So that he emphasized. So this anxiety can be considered as a disruptive force which blocks our development and good interpersonal relationship. Appo ee continuous aitulla tension or anxiety, if it happens, it can be considered as a disruptive force. And why it is considered as a disruptive force? Because it blocks our development as well as it blocks our good interpersonal relationship. And we know, and it is said that the people develop their personality in the social context. That is what Harry Stack Sullivan says. That means people develop their personality in the social context, because she emphasized on the interaction with other people, especially with the significant members of the family. And through this way, with the interaction with the significant members of the family as well as with the other people, people develop the personality. So we can say that many people develop the personality in the social context. And if we have any other relationship or with other people, we would have if he doesn't have any other good relationship, any good relationship with other people, then what happened? We would have no personality. That is what Harry Stack Sullivan says. Appa namukku social interactions koravana, relationship illa, society maayitte we have no connection, then what happened? Then according to Harry Stack Sullivan, we would have no personality. That is what she says. So our development depends on our ability to establish intimacy with other people. That is very important. Appa social interpersonal relationship allengil people's interaction with other people, that is very important. And if we are unable or we show some inability to establish the intimacy with other people, then it will definitely affect our personality. So anxiety can interfere with establishing satisfying interpersonal relationship. If anxiety arises inside the person, then what happens? It will interfere with establishing satisfying interpersonal relationship. And she emphasized on attention, then energy transformation, because she says that the tensions, it creates anxiety, then drowsiness, and the person will not always be on a conscious level, then partial distortion from reality. All these things happen. And usually, according to Harris Tack Sullivan, he says that the tension arises from needs. And she classified the needs into two types. So she gave enough importance to the needs also. Needs are classified into two types. First is personal needs. And the second is general needs. So what do you mean by sonal needs? Sonal needs means it arises from the specific body part. So the body also has some needs. So sonal needs means it arises from the specific body part. And general need means it is the overall well-being of a person. And here he mentioned other word, that is tenderness. Tenderness means you know what is tenderness. So tenderness, Harris Tack Sullivan, he considered it as a basic interpersonal need. Tenderness, Harris Tack Sullivan, he considered it as a basic interpersonal need. And he also emphasized on energy transformation. Energy transformation. So when we become tensed, according to this theory, energy transformation means when we experience anxiety or the tension arises inside an individual, what happens? The energy, it is transformed either into covert actions or overt or covert actions. What do you mean by covert action, overt behavior, or like a covert behavior? What is that?
Overt is more of exposing, ma'am, like exposing, coming to the friend and showing, and covert is like hiding somewhere and doing some actions.
Okay. Suppose if a person experiences tension or anxiety, some energy transformation occurs. That means the energy, it is transformed either into overt action. Overt action means anything that can be observed. Sometimes it may be some disruptive behavior, or it can be some covert action. Some aggression will be there inside the mind. So it can be the energy transformation. It can be either to overt or covert actions. And then this type of behavior, that is either it can be, I mentioned that it can be either overt or covert behavior. And this type of behavior that satisfy our needs reduces anxiety. Okay, if the behavior can be either overt or covert, and what happens, this type of behavior, either it is covert or overt or covert, whatever it be, it satisfy our needs. It is a behavior that satisfy our needs, and finally the result is it reduces the anxiety. Sometimes, so we can say that it can be either for good or bad. And he also mentioned about the term called the malevolence. In this theory, he also mentioned about the malevolence. What is called the malevolence? Malevolent. Means the person means with they wish evil on others. What is the opposite of malevolent? Benevolent, have you heard of the benevolent? Means wishing good things for others. So a malevolent person exhibits satisfaction at someone else's problem. He experienced some sort of satisfaction. So that we can say that such personality will be very cruel or antisocial personality. Again, he mentioned about the word.
It's malicious influence, ma'am. Malevolence means malicious influence.
Malicious influence in the sense? Can you please make it clear?
Any malicious activity, like influencing others on malicious activities, like.
Okay. And any sort of antisocial behavior.
Correct. Yes. Through this behavior, the other people get influenced. Like.
Influenced. Okay.
As a leader who is not in.
Okay. Please continue. Leader.
Any leader, suppose he is like exposing his bad behaviors. So others get influenced with that.
The followers also will get influenced by that leader's behavior. That is what you mean?
Yes.
Okay. Anyway, the malevolent person may exhibit some sort of satisfaction by seeing others' problem. So that we can say that he will, a slight cruelty will be there. Then antisocial personality, lack of empathy. All those things will be clearly evident in a malevolent person. And another thing is that he mentioned the word lust. Then usually we can say that another thing is about the here also a malevolent person, he lacks intimacy. There will not be any close association with others, and it increases the loneliness as well as anxiety. So in contrast to this malevolence, there are some people who have this sort of intimacy. They maintain some sort of intimacy with other people. That means that they have a close association with other people, and it decreases the loneliness. And finally, Haristack Sullivan says that it decreases the anxiety among people. So these are some of the terms used by Haristack Sullivan in his theory. So you please go through the lecture notes. That is today first I mentioned about the first theory. What was the first theory I mentioned today? About Skinner's theory. Skinner's operant conditioning. Then the second. What is the second?
Law of effect.
Law of effect by Thorndike. Then, pardon?
Karen Horney.
Karen Horney. You have to pronounce it as Karen Horney.
Horney.
Okay, then Haristack Sullivan. Please go through these four theories. Because any other theories or other class will come, because my throat is not okay. 2 hours continuous class means it is very hectic for me. Okay, please go through the theories, and if any doubt comes in between, you please ask me.
Ma'am, will you be sharing all this presentation to the main group, because so that we'll be able to revise it?
Okay, at the end of the class, I'll do. One more class is there, no? Next week, it will be over. So yes. After that, I'll share it.
Some instructors used to do a YouTube video and send it, so that there will be an instructions also, like your voice also there.
Okay, that I'll tell the IGNO center.
Yes, madam. Okay.
Because I can't share it. They have to share it.
No, if you can kindly share the presentation and the group, it will be beneficial, ma'am. Yes.
And that is what the coordinator told me, that they have to send it.
Yes.
I'm not supposed to send it. So I will ask this, I'll present this request. so that they will send it to you. Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
In Harry's talk, Savilian Theory, you gave the definition of tension. So I didn't get it. It creates a biological impact between?
Biological imbalance. Imbalance between the internal and external environment. Suppose when we experience anxiety, anxiety experience in the samayath, definitely some outward incident will be there. At the same time, it is creating some physiological changes in our body.
Okay, ma'am.
So that is the imbalance between the external and internal environment. Ippo nammal aalochikkuka, ippo suppose when we become panic, so many body changes or physiological changes happens. Just like sometimes the blood pressure, it will come up, then the blood flow, the brain activity, then palpitation will come out, sweating, all those things happen, no? So that is why, so we see that so many physiological changes happens inside our body. So some disequilibrium, sometimes is a disequilibrium, it happens between the internal and external environment. So internal environment means our bodily changes.
Okay, ma'am. I have one basic doubt actually. So when I joined the course, from the day one I'm having this doubt. So yes, we have been studying the kind of theories and what is happening and everything. Are we going to study about the solution of these problems?
Definitely, because after completing the PG course, you are supposed to be thorough with all the theories. And these theories we have to apply in various situations. That is very important. Suppose if you are working in the future, if you are working in the clinic, definitely these theories will be very helpful to you to find out the correct problem of the person. So in the application level, we have to apply all these things. That is why the theories are considered to be very important. In whatever be the subjects, all the theories are considered very important. So in the application level, we have to make use of it. Okay. I don't know this. We are completing the whole theories of personality within 10 hours.
Okay, ma'am. What is the, next PG for personality theories? I want to get it myself for a behavior therapist. So what is the further course can be done after this?
Usually after MA, if you want to practice as a clinical psychologist, you have to do the MPhil in clinical psychology. So only very few institutions are offering MPhil in clinical psychology. That is, one is a very few good institutions. I would like to say that the good institutions, that is, one is from NIMHANS. NIMHANS, they are offering, I think only 4 or 5 seats are there. Then Ranji, CAP is offering. Then I think that is Manipal University, that also KMC, no? Yes. That also started. Then I think Amrita Hospital also, one course, they recently started, but I doubt whether it is running now. I'm not sure about it. These are some of the institutions which they are offering the clinical psychology. After completing the clinical psychology, you can work as a clinical psychologist. But nowadays, this PhD, that is also mandatory, because any clinic or any institution, they ask for the PhD. Even if you are in the teaching field, that PhD, it has become mandatory now.
Yes, ma'am. And after the MPhil psychology also, the person can be work as a, I mean, for because I'm the mother of autism child.
Okay. I'm
on spectrum. The people kept doing the assessment.
So after completing the clinical psychology, you can do all the assessment because...
Yes, only I can do the assessment. My query is, I want to become a behavioral therapist.
Yes. So
that what can be done, ma'am? Like
that first you have to register as a counselor. Once you are qualified, you have to register as a counselor in the RCA.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. That is very important. Without registration, you can't work as a counselor. Actually, okay. That is the rule.
Okay. And I have come across that Behavioral Momentum of India. So they are offering some courses for the behavioral therapist. I mean, we can modify the behaviors in our children. So how about that course, ma'am?
Any university is offering?
No, it's actually Behavioral Momentum. Actually, the main center is in Australia. So now they have started in India, Behavioral Momentum of India. They are offering some behavioral therapist courses. So I'm like, after completing the MPhil psychology, clinical psychology also, I can do only the assessment, right, no, ma'am? I mean...
Assessment you can do.
After assessment, can I get into any practical, therapy sessions? Like
Definitely you can practice. Definitely after completing the MPhil in clinical psychology, you can practice as a clinical psychologist. So the main responsibilities of the clinical psychologist is diagnosing and doing some intervention techniques. So intervention techniques in the sense you have to do various sorts of therapies and all. And assessment, you have to rely on various tests for the diagnosis. So once you complete the clinical psychology, that means you are thorough with all the tests.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay.
Okay, thank you.
As well as the therapy also, you become very thorough after completing this in clinical psychology. I'm mentioning, I'm stressing the point, clinical psychology.
Yes, ma'am. Actually, I have gone through the assessment for my son from clinical psychology. And later on, I switched to the behavioral therapist classes. So, she's completed the MPhil clinical psychology, but in bracket, they have mentioned behavioral therapist. So, her class is actually very good, and my son is very progressive. He has given some sorting and coding and activities and all, and home-based activities.
Okay.
So activities, my son is becoming very progressive, and his behavioral also controlled. So that is what I'm mentioning. If I complete only the MPhil psychology, will it work, or I have to go for the personality, behavioral therapist courses or something?
But in India, if you want to practice as a clinical psychologist, you have to complete the MPhil course in clinical psychology. That is very, very important nowadays.
Which is only in regular, no, ma'am?
Regular.
Okay.
That is 2 years, I think.
Yes, but recently I heard about that from the new education policy. They have banned
the... Yeah, they had withdrawn that policy. Now, even now, the NIMHANS as well as this KMC, they are offering this CAP, all are offering the MPhil course.
Okay.
Ma'am, after this course, can we start as a psychologist, like practice as psychologist?
I won't recommend.
Okay.
ബിക്കോസ് ഇപ്പോൾ ഞങ്ങളൊക്കെ എംഫില്ല് ഞാനൊക്കെ എംഫില്ല് ചെയ്ത സമയത്ത് എന്ന് വെച്ച് കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ മോർണിംഗ് വി ഹാവ് ദ റെഗുലർ ക്ലാസ് ആൻഡ് ആഫ്റ്റർനൂൺ വി ഹാവ് ദ ക്ലിനിക് സോ വി വിൽ ഹാവ് വി ആർ മീറ്റിംഗ് വെയിറ്റ് ഡിഫറെൻ്റ് ടൈപ്സ് ഓഫ് പേഷ്യൻസ് ഇൻ ദ ക്ലിനിക് സോ വിൽ ഗെറ്റ് എൻ ഐഡിയ ഓഫ് വാട്ട് ആർ ദ സിംറ്റംസ് ഓഫ് മാനിയ വാട്ട് ആർ ദ സിംറ്റംസ് ഓഫ് ഡിപ്രഷൻ അത് നമ്മൾ സ്ട്രെയിറ്റ് ആയിട്ട് കണ്ടാണ് പരിചയിക്കുന്നത് ബട്ട് നൗ യു ആർ ഡൂയിങ് this type of course and I don't know how much you are aware of this each and every symptoms
ma'am in Kerala only Amrita is there Amrita offering clinical psychology
I think some other edakyo salangal undu but I'm not sure about it but ettu nallathu NIMHANS and Ranchi that
NIMHANS le we need to attend that entrance no ma'am
yeah entrance is very tough
okay
Very, very tough. Both this Ranchi also, the entrance is very tough. NIMHANS also.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. നിങ്ങള് ബെസ്റ്റ് എന്ന് വെച്ചാൽ ഇന്റേൺഷിപ്പിന്റെ ഇനിയിപ്പോ ഇന്റേൺഷിപ്പ് ഒക്കെ വരുന്ന സമയത്ത് ആ ടൈമില് ഒരു നല്ല ഹോസ്പിറ്റലിൽ പോയിട്ട് മാക്സിമം കേസസ് നിങ്ങൾ മനസ്സിലാക്കുക. ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ദ ഓൺലി തിങ് യു കൻ ഡു. Get the basic foundation of psychology. Psychology is basic, because you haven't done, many of you haven't done the degree course. No? Degree course cheyidine shesham ningale PG cheyumba adina indeyaya vyathasam undu. Appa degree kazhinja shesham because I mean during the internship time you better you select a very good place for your internship so that you will be familiar with the cases and all.
So that internship is also provided by NIMHANS, no ma'am? Because I had been in NIMHANS.
Yeah. NIMHANS variety of cases are there.
Okay.
And the people are also thorough in the subject. That is the main thing.
Yes, ma'am. I started my son treatment from NIMHANS.
NIMHANS only. What's your name?
My name is Shanti.
Shanti. Okay. Shanti, Shanti.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, okay.
Actually, I stepped into NIMHANS for my son's assessment, and there only I know about the reinforcement.
Mm-hmm.
What can be done, oral reinforcement.
Yeah, because in autistic children, reinforcement plays a very important role.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Behavior modification and everything.
Yes, yes, yes. And they started from reinforcement. Now, I got some kind of knowledge from there, but still I'm practicing that knowledge.
But is your son's age now?
Now he's 12 years old.
12 years. Is he attending any special school or something like that?
No, ma'am. He's going to regular school only. But now the problem is a socialization. He's lacking in socialization and the emotional fluctuations.
Okay.
So I try to put him to get into yoga. I completed some few yoga courses also. But
okay.
That didn't work for him.
Okay.
But the thing is, after I continued my therapy in Bangalore and he studied his monetary training classes in Bangalore itself. So that time he was so progressive. But after coming here, unfortunately, I couldn't find the proper therapies, the occupational therapies.
So I think, where you are staying? Ernakulam?
Staying in Alwa.
Alwa. Ernakulam, one Vigyan Valley is there.
Vigyan Valley is a learning center. I had been there, ma'am. Actually, I had a Prayatna center from Balaram. And I got a speech therapy from Ranai Medicines.
Ranai Medicines.
Yes, I went to the Sunrise. I think her name is, I forgot her name now. She is in Dubai, but she's very good behavioral therapist. Diana.
Diana.
Yes. And after going Sunrise Hospital, Diana's classes was excellent.
Okay.
Now, and unfortunately, she's not here now.
Okay.
And then I went to Dr. Jagadambika. Dr. Jagadambika in
Alwa. Alwa.
Yes. I went there 2-3 years back.
Okay.
She told me your son is very advanced. Only the doctorate people, I mean, highly experienced people only handle him.
So
please don't go for this. I mean, just finished course, finished people and all, don't go there. And she suggested me.
Okay.
Still, I gone many therapy centers and new classes and all. And I also worked in a rehabilitation center as a yoga teacher.
Okay.
And there also find so many difficulties. But he's not in right hand, ma'am, right now. But still, he's lacking somewhere.
Okay.
And got an admission in a school. But still, I don't know if I take him to another, my native place. My native place is Tamil Nadu.
Okay.
So if I'm changing him, I don't know what are the problems I'm going to face.
Okay. I think near UC College, one clinic is the
Pragati?
It is not Pragati.
Alpha Rehabilitation Center?
Alpha, I think.
Yes. I had been working as a yoga teacher 1 year back.
Okay. And then?
So there also, I didn't find, because they keep changing the therapies to like special educators and all.
Okay. Uh-huh.
And not specific behavior is modified like Bangalore. So
okay.
Once we tell about...
Anyway, we know, we all know that Bangalore is the best.
Yes. That's what I put myself into the course. But I'm after doing this, I'm thinking that whether I'll get any solution for the problem or because people are experienced, people are keep on giving the activities which will modify the behavior. So am I getting that knowledge after completion of this course? That is a doubt of mine.
I can't give you any surety regarding that. because this mode of teaching, and I can't, what to say, I don't know what to say.
It comes out of experience. And
yeah, experience plays a very important thing.
Yes, ma'am.
That is why I mentioned that you just select a very good place for your internship.
Mm-hmm.
You can learn a lot through during this internship period.
Mm-hmm. Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. So, shall we wind up?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. See you next week. So, happy Christmas, all of you.
Thank you, ma'am.
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 Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Wish you the same.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.